Hello everyone, I am Sachin Rathod, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from college Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we will see the next part of the break. The learning outcome of this session is student will able to understand the working of simple band break. So this is a schematic diagram of simple band break, on which one lever is there. That lever, one rope is attached or the band is attached. On that band, the frictional material is lying. So when we are pulling that lever by an amount of force P in the upward direction, then the rotating drum will get stopped. So we'll see this in detail. So you can think about this, what are the applications of simple band break. So the first thing is that the simple band break is mostly used in the parking brake or the hacksaw machine. So this is a simple diagram of band on which the two hooks are there. We are attaching that two hooks to the lever, and in between that hook the rotating drum is there. So when we are pulling force P on the lever, then the rotating drum will get stopped. So we will see the derivation for this simple band break for finding the braking torque or the force applied at the end of the lever. So already we have seen the simple band break means one disc is there, and this disc, the rope is attached, this is our lever, here by using one pin we are attaching one end of the rope at this end or the belt, and this is our the fulcrum, this is the one end of the lever. And at the another end, we are applying the P in the upward direction. So in that figure, this is the angle theta, that is called as the angle of the lap. The portion which is covered by the belt, that is called as the angle of the lap. It is denoted by the letter theta. This is a radius R, that is the radius of the drum R. So this is the lever. This is lever, this is a fulcrum, and this is a force P applied in the upward direction. This is a distance in between, or the it is a distance of the lever, that is denoted by the letter L. It is a distance from fulcrum to the pin, that is denoted by the letter A. And when we apply the force at one end of the lever in the upward direction, then tension will created in the rope or the belt. So if the drum will get rotated in the clockwise direction, the tension T1 is acts in this side, and this is the tension T2, where T1 is nothing but tension in the tight side, and the T2 is nothing but tension in the slack side. So here we have to calculate the braking torque. So this is a simple diagram of the simple band break, and one thing you have to remember that on this rope or the belt, the frictional material are lying. So due to the friction in between that, the frictional material which is on this belt, and there is a friction between your the drum. So due to that two friction occurs, your the rotating drum will get stopped. So we will see the how to calculate the braking torque. So one thing we are knowing, the limiting equation, the limiting equation of the belt. So from the belt chapter we are knowing that, so if the T1 and T2 are the tension in the tight side and the slack side respectively, then the ratio of tension in the tight side to the tension in the slack side, T1 by T2, is equal to e raised to mu theta, where T1 is nothing but tension in the tight side, T2 is the tension in the slack side, mu is a coefficient of friction between the rotating drum and the belt, and theta is the angle of the lamp. So this is the one equation, that is the relation between T1 and T2. The second thing is that we are knowing that braking torque TB is equal to T1 minus T2 into the radius r, radius of the drum. So this is the equation of the braking torque. If in the given data, if you are knowing the effective radius, so we can get the equation T1 minus T2 into RE, where RE is nothing but the effective radius. If the thickness of the belt they had given us, or if you are knowing the thickness of the belt, so we can consider the RE, where RE is equal to R plus T by 2, where T is nothing but thickness of the belt. So by using this equation, we can easily get the value of braking torque. So here we have to find out the value of force P. So for finding the value of the force P, there are the two conditions are acting. So one thing is that the drum will get rotated in the clockwise direction, or it may be rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. So we will see these two conditions. So first one, the drum rotates in the clockwise direction. So if drum will get rotates in the clockwise direction, at that time drum will get rotated in the clockwise direction, here the force P is applied. So as the it is rotated in the clockwise direction, the maximum tension will occur in this belt, so it is denoted by the letter T1, and the minimum tension, that is slack, will occur on this belt, it is denoted by the letter T2, and this is our the fulcrum O. This is a length of the lever, and this is the distance between your the pin and the fulcrum, that is a A. So we have to take the moment about the O, moment about O. So by taking the moment about O, we are getting that is a force P into L, it is acting in the upward direction, and T1 into A, so is equal to T1 into A. Therefore P is equal to T1 into A divided by the L. So this is a equation of force P. And the second case is, if the drum will get rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. So second case, anti-clockwise direction. So we are getting the diagram like this. This is a rotating drum. This is a position of the belt. This is a lever. This is a fulcrum. Here one end of the rope is attached by the pin. Here the force P is applied. Now this drum will get rotates in anti-clockwise direction. At that time, so we are getting that the tension will occur, the maximum tension in the tight side will occur at this position, it is denoted by the letter T1, and this will give the T2, tension in the slack side. So we are getting that, take the moment about O, this is a fulcrum O. So we are getting that P into this distance L is equal to, this distance is A, T2 into A. Therefore we are getting P is equal to T2 into A divided by L. So by this way we can easily get the value of P. So from this equations we are getting the, if you are knowing the how much amount of the force P is applied, we are getting the value of T2, and by knowing the value of T2, put this value of the T2 in this equation. So now we are knowing the value of the coefficient of friction and the angle of the lap theta, we are getting the value of T1. So if you are knowing the T1 and T2, we can easily get the braking torque. So these are my references. Thank you.